Hello there, welcome to another Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes video. Today we'll be discussing these new packs, their values, and if you should buy them, which is totally up to you. So let's first talk about the methodology and how I did this. So I took all the packs, the contents of the packs, and I converted each of those elements into crystals. Crystals have a known quantity of cost. You can see exactly how much they are. So that's the best way to price these packs out. Now, that said, crystals are entirely subjective to you personally. Your $99 for one person is a whole lot. For another person, that may be chump change. And if it's chump change, hey, give me some money because I could use it. Anyway, all these packs are going to be very subjective based on your disposable income. So it's up to you what you buy. Please do not spend money that you can't afford to throw away on a game. I added all the value of the items in the pack up as crystals. Then the value of the pack was determined by what it would cost to purchase an equivalent number of crystals. What this cannot do is some of the items are not in the store, like the ability tokens and the signal data. So in that case, for the ability tokens, I used fleet currency kind of as an approximate value. You can buy Zeta mats with 2,000 fleet arena tokens. You can buy Omegas with 1,500, which I think is really overpriced, but it is what it is. The signal data, you can't buy either, at least I couldn't. If you can, tell me how. So the way I did that is with Cantina refreshes. If you were to buy a Cantina refresh, you get 120 Cantina energy, costs 100 crystals. So I did an average drop rate of 1.5 for the fragmented data, 1.25 for the incomplete data, and 1 per sim for the flawed signal data. That's the best average drop rate that I've seen. You know, that's I think that's pretty fair. So that's not 100% accurate though. And that also, again, like I said, that doesn't take into account time, because now you're spending your Cantina refreshes on this instead of, you know, on character farming. So we'll take a look at these packs. The first one, this Medium Galactic Legend Relic Bundle. You can see all the things you get. A couple of the notable things here. The Electrium Conductor is the best part of this pack by far. These first three are really about worthless. You won't have really much trouble getting plenty of these. I don't, and I'm... My main account has only been around for about a year. They're not really worth much. The Erodium Heat Sinks, they're worth something. The Zimbiddle cards, they're worth something, but not quite as much as you would think. The Electrium Conductor is really where it's at. The Signal Data is very helpful, saves a lot of time, but ultimately it's not the best value in credits. You can buy credits in game, so I had a good price for that. But again, that's subjective. If you've had an account in the game for years, you probably don't need any credits. But if you're brand new, a million credits might really be able to help you out. Then again, the cost of getting a character from level 1 to 85 is something like 6.5 million, so a million's not going to go that far. So the total pack value for this is $65 if you were to buy the pack. And it costs $65, so it's a value to cost of 1. So we're just dividing that number by the cost. So let's take a look at this next pack. This is the Lightspeed Zeta Bundle. So here's what you get. You 5,000 crystals, 2 million credits. You get MK1, 2, and 3 ability tokens. MK1 and 2 ability tokens are worthless. You've been in the game for a long time, MK3 ability tokens are worthless. So, it's really dependent on where you're at. The Omega ability mats are very good. not quite as good maybe for someone that's been in the game for a long time. The Zeta mats are good, but again, like, that's 1/4 of a Zeta. 1/4. Like, you get a Zeta per day, roughly, with all the events going on. You know, you get 4 per day just from the fleet challenges, or 4 per week, excuse me, for the fleet challenges. So it's 5 days. It's not as good as you would hope. Carbonite circuit boards, bronzium wiring, again, all that stuff. You know, the relic stuff isn't the best. Unfortunately, it's not the best value in the game. You do get signal data. Again, that's not bad. The Chirotechs are very helpful. Unfortunately, it's only 35. If you're going to do anything, you need at least 50, so you still have to farm some more or have some more before you can even equip something. So the total pack value here is about $123. It's a value to cost of 1.23. This is a $99 pack. That's a lot, and it's not the best value. It is better than buying straight crystals, but I would pass on this one, unless you're a super whale. All right, the injector bundle pack. So there's 4 of these. There's a Rose Tico, a Finn, a Sith Trooper, and a Poe. They're all the exact same, just different titles. They all come with 1,500 crystals, the 50 injector cell salvage, 50 Chirotech shock prod salvage, 25 of the droid collars, which I believe is a raid-only item. I mean, you can find them in stores, but you can't farm them, per se. And 25 of the Armatech Fusion Furnace Salvage. All those are very difficult to acquire gear pieces. Crystals are straight up crystals. Yeah, I mean, that's always good to have. So this is actually a pretty good pack. If you want multiple, you can buy them up to 4. But so the total pack value there is $36.50. With a value cost of 1.46, that's much better than our last pack. The last pack we just talked about was 1.23, and this is 1.46, so we're really getting better. But the next one's really where it's at. The Medium Galactic Legends Gear Bundle. This has all sorts of Gear 12. I won't read all that. But just to break it down for you, you'll notice there's a lot of similar stuff here. The Armatech Thermal Detonator components and the prototypes. So this and this will be 2/3 of what's required for a certain gear. Let me see if I can actually pull it up on a character here for you, so that you can see exactly what I'm talking about. Hold on a second. Okay, so this is General Kenobi. He needs this Armatech HoloLens. So you'll see the HoloLens component is made up of several different items, and the prototype is just that part of it. But you still need something else in all of them. So it's not going to be a complete gear piece. It's 2/3 of a gear piece. It's the hardest parts of the gear piece, I think, to get. And you're getting 4. So 4 2/3. Gear pieces. Plus you're getting some other really good gear. The biotech implant components are needed by everyone. Stun guns needed by everyone. Droid collars needed for everyone. Stun cuffs needed by almost everybody. So the total pack value here is $131. That's a value to cost of 2.01. So, I mean, you're doubling your money if you buy this pack. Now, again, like I say, you're not actually doubling your money because you're spending $65 on a game, but if you're going to spend money in the game, this is the best value out currently. So, look at this little pack comparison. It's going to be a little chart. So I've got a cost of value going up. As you can see, the gear bundle's the best one. The injector bundle's next. Lightspeed bundle, then the relic bundle. But unless you're wanting to save time, you might as well just buy crystals there. And this is the cost. So I I'm not the best with PowerPoint, but this is what I came up with. So it's you know, $65, $100, $25, $65. So in conclusion, all the packs are at least as good as buying straight crystals. You do save a lot of time, so there is something for that. If you're going to be spending money, saving time is good. That's presumably why you're spending money. Like I said, the relic materials cost more, but they save time. That's really hard to qualify, so that's very subjective to you. If you're farming other stuff in Cantina, that might be more valuable to you. So the best value is clear that the gear bundle, that gear 12 stuff is really hard to acquire. Most of it comes from raids. You can farm some of it, but you know, the non-gear 12 stuff is also super valuable, needed by everybody. The best cheap value is the injector bundle packs for the $25. The best overall value is the gear bundle. So please like and subscribe if this video was helpful to you. If you want to see more videos like this, please leave a note in the comments. This is something I could make into a series if people are interested. But if nobody likes this video or comments, then I may never do this again. So if this was helpful, please let me know. Please share to others so that CG stops ripping people off for crap Lightspeed bundle packs. And I hope you all have a blessed day. Stay safe, and I'll see you on the next video.